This experiment, we are going to look at welding. So welding is a fabrication or sculptural process that joins metals together. Okay, or joins materials, usually metals or thermoplastics, by causing fusion. So what this means is the metal parts are joined together by heating up something which we call the base metal, and we add something called a filler metal between these base metal in order to make the connection. Okay, so let us see what are the different types of welding. So there is metal inert gas welding, which is called MIG welding, and they also give it another name, which is GMAW. That is gas metal arc welding. Okay, so these are the different names given for MIG welding. Second kind is called tungsten inert gas welding, GTAW, which is gas tungsten arc welding. And the last kind is stick welding, which is called shielding metal arc welding. Okay, so let's see what are each of these welding techniques. I'm just checking if you guys are able to see. I think it is shown now. Okay, so what is MIG welding? I'm just going to play a video and then I will explain while the video is playing. So what is MIG? It is metal inert gas welding, and sometimes called gas metal arc welding or wire welding. So it typically consists of a spool gun and something called as the flux core wire, the thing that I'm pointing now. Okay, so this machine automatically releases the wire through something which we call the spool gun. Okay, and this is how it looks like. So there is a button over here which you need to press in order to release the wire through the spool gun. Okay, and this wire, it is actually helping to fill using the filler. The wire is a filler material used to fill the gap between the base metal and the part that you want to weld together. Okay, so let's watch this. So here they're just showing how the welding process is working. So from here the material gets distributed between the joints. So the base metal is shown here and the filler material. So the base metal, this is just a sheet which is laying horizontal. And this is a vertical sheet, the top. Okay, so the vertical sheet is placed like a T shape on the horizontal sheet, and we are just trying to weld these two pieces of metal together. So what he has done is he's holding these together and he's using the filler metal, which is the coil inside, to fill the gap between, or to merge these two pieces of metal together. Okay, so since the material that is coming through the electrode, it is being used for doing the welding process, it is called a consumable electrode. So what does consumable mean? It means that something that will get consumed over time. So with time, the filler material will get used and you may have to replace the filler material. Okay, so this is called a consumable electrode. This is just showing how the wire is coming out. There is a conduit liner. This is in order to ensure that the wire is coming straight without bending, since from a huge diameter you are coming to a small diameter. So it's just to ensure that the wire is coming straight. And this is how the gun looks like. It has a contact tip. And it has a gas diffuser. We will see why it has a gas diffuser in a while. So there is something called shielding gas, which is this cloud that you see over here. So what shielding gas does is it prevents any kind of oxidation from occurring. So when you're welding, if oxidation occurs, the weld will not be a clean weld. So in order to ensure that the material, the base metal or the material, the filler material does not get contaminated or get oxidized, we have to use something called shielding gas. And this is the gas that is coming through the diffuser that we saw earlier. Okay, so this is the gas diffuser. So the shielding gas comes from these holes that you see here. And the shielding gas is usually stored in large cylinders like this. And it typically consists of inert gas, which is argon, and a little bit percentage of carbon dioxide as well. It's like 70% argon, 30% carbon dioxide, and so on. There are different mixtures, but the typical one that is used is using argon and CO2 mixture. So the gas, the amount that it comes is controlled using a regulator. So this regulator, it is similar to the cooking gas regulator that you have at home. But in here, we have different dials to ensure how much is the pressure inside the cylinder and how much is the pressure that is coming out from the regulator. Okay. So depending on the requirement of the welding machine, we'll have to supply the gas. Now, this is a typical control unit for the welding machine. It has the feed rate here, the speed at which the wire is supposed to come out from the spool gun, the voltmeter. Depending on the material that you are working with, you have to adjust the voltage. Then we have the polarity over here. The polarity is to ensure there are different modes that we can operate the machine at. One is DCEP, which is called direct current electrode positive. DCEN, direct current electrode negative, and AC, which is alternating current. So let's see what is the difference between these and how it is connected typically for a MIG welding machine. So this is the polarity, the wire speed, and the voltage. We can see the electrode, and the electrode is positive, right? And the base metal is negative. So in this case, which polarity are we using? It is actually DCEP, which is electrode positive direct current. Direct current because the polarity is not changing. It's not becoming minus and plus. It's constant at minus here and it's constant plus here. So this is direct current electrode positive technique. And it is also referred to as reverse polarity. Okay, so now the connection is shown. Here we have something called the work lead. And this is the welding machine. So the welding machine has the gun which is coming here, the base metal, and to the base metal we are attaching something which is called the work lead. This is how the circuit is complete. If you don't have the work lead connected, welding will not occur. Okay. So this work lead, we can also refer to it as ground. And here they're just summarizing what all is involved in MIG welding. So it involves arc welding, and it uses a consumable electrode, and the filler metal is automatic, which is coming through the spool gun.
and we need to have shielding gas which is stored in
the cylinder, gas cylinder.
Continue with TIG welding. TIG is known as tungsten inert gas welding or gas tungsten arc welding. This is given different names. Also, they call it heli arc welding. So we have a tungsten filament, which is used as the electrode. Now, in this case, the tungsten, it is a non-consumable electrode, meaning that we don't have to replace the tungsten rod unless the life of the tungsten is over. But in the case of MIG welding, the wire was being consumed when you are doing the welding process. Here, the electrode is not being consumed. TIG, we don't have a consumable electrode. So this is attached to a collet and a collet body. And it has an end cap. So this is fixed here, it's not moving, and it only provides an arc, an electric arc. And what this basically is doing is it is melting the two pieces of metals, and the melted points just fuse into each other. So that is the fusion, the word that you saw in the beginning with the definition of welding. So the two pieces of metals are joined together or fused together. Okay. It can be controlled by foot pedal, or there is sometimes a thumb throttle. And again, here he is explaining about the direct current principle. So it is a constant positive, constant negative. So in this case, you can see that the electrode is negative while the base metal is positive, for the work lead is positive. Okay. So this type of welding, the polarity is DCEN. The direct current electrode is negative. Okay. So let's see. This is called DCEN. And it is having a straight polarity. So the amount, the heat is generated due to the electric arc. He is also explaining about the alternating current that can be used here. So in the case of alternating current, you can see that the positive and negative was keeping on changing. So what is happening is the alternating current can be used to reduce the oxidation, but not completely prevent it. It will give a somewhat better finish than while not using any gas or while using DC. So it's just to improve the finish slightly, but again, it's not the most perfect method of preventing oxidation. Again, he is mentioning that the circuit must be complete in order for the welding machine to work. So the electrode and the base metal and the work lead has to be connected in this manner. And now he has added something over here, which is the external filler rod. This filler rod, in case the metals do not fuse by themselves, we can inject another piece of metal, which is a filler metal, in order to ensure that the materials have fused together or joined together. Okay. So he will mention now, it's called a filler rod. And this technique is similar to doing the soldering process. You have soldering. you typically try to connect wires to connectors or to other wires using soldering. So soldering, we have a soldering iron and a wire. The wire is typically melted in order to join the two wires together. So in this case, we are doing the same thing. This is the heater, and this is the material that will be melted and fused between the two metals. So this welding is more, let's say, similar to soldering. And again, shielding gas is provided externally. There are two options, by the way, for the shielding gas. One could be an external like this, and in MIG welding, sometimes the machine has a small internal cylinder. So depending on the size of the job that you have to do, you can either external cylinder, or you just require small job, then you can use the internal cylinder, which is inside the machine itself. So stick welding uses a stick like this, and it's also referred to as shielded metal arc welding. Now it's called shielded because the electrode itself, one second, when they show the electrode, I will explain. That's the electrode, and the electric arc is generated when the circuit is complete. And the electrode itself is used as a filler material again, similar to the MIG welding. But in this case, instead of a wire, we have a consumable electrode, which is a filler metal. So this is the consumable electrode, and as you can see, the consumable electrode has a covering or coating. This is actually having the shielding gas present inside it. So as this melts, the shielding gas is distributed in the environment, and hence you don't need any external gas cylinder or internal gas cylinder to do the shielding. The covering itself will do this. So this is the difference between stick welding and the other two types of welding. The shielding gas is within the consumable. And once the covering is used to generate the shielding gas, another component is formed on the top surface, which is called slag. It would be better to see what slag is. That is better to explain. So as you can see here, the top thing that he just moved is the slag. So once you do the welding, you will have this black surface being built over the weld. Once the weld has cooled down, we can remove it. Okay. So this is actually from the material getting burned and doing the shielding. So after shielding, it provides this kind of shell, which is called slag. And once the welding is cooled, the surface is cooled, you can remove this slag easily. We don't require an external cylinder. And this is how the controls look like for a typical stick welding machine. It has a polarity and current, because there is no feeding wire, so there is no feed rate control. So it's just the current and the polarity. Now, depending on how you hold the electrode, the welding finish or the surface finish of the weld would be different. Here he is showing how the full circuit is going to be made. There is the work lead, and that's the electrode or the grip end, we call it this time. So this grip is just holding the electrode, and you just need to touch the surface that you need to weld. If it is AC, as you can see, the polarity keeps changing. And for DC, you can use either AC or DC, but depending on what the manufacturer or the one who designed the part has advised you to use, depending on that, you have to change the polarity. So this is DCEN, electronegative, trade polarity. And DCEP, we will show now, which is the reverse polarity and electrode positive. So this is an example of a table that is provided by the manufacturer. So he has mentioned the type of current or the polarity that you have to use. Let's say for the first one, it is DCEP. For the second one, it's AC or DCEP. So you can use either one, AC or DCEN, and any of the three, and so on. So depending on the job that you have, there are some standards. This is called American Welding Standard 5.1. Depending on what material you're doing, there will be different tables. And depending on this table, you have to choose what polarity you're going to set. Okay. I think the bigger version of the... Yeah, you can see the classification. So depending on the electrode type as well, the electrode is E6010. So depending on the number that you have purchased for the electrode, you know what is the type of covering from here, what is the welding position from here, and what is the polarity here. And again, this is just showing how the electrode is made. It can be from different materials. And typically, the electrode has a code like this, as we saw in the previous table. So this is just mentioning it's an electrode. The 60 is the tensile strength. And this is the covering and the positions that you can use. And also sometimes there are some other at the end. And depending on the tables that we have, they have different meanings. Now this is for the arc welding. It's also an arc welding process. It uses a consumable electrode. The shielding gas is within the cover of the electrode, and this is the slag, and this is how the naming is done for the electrode. So this is the last slide. It's talking about the types of joints that we have. A lap joint is when you have one piece of metal over the other, and the one edge of each piece of metal is joined to the surface of another metal. So this edge of this metal is joined to the surface of this material. Then it is called a lap joint. Now why I explain this in detail is the edge joint, the lap joint are kind of similar. In the edge joint, the two edges have to be joined. While here, one edge is joined to a surface, the other end is joined to a surface. This is the difference between lap joint and edge joint. So some students typically confuse between these two. Then we have a T joint. This is very easy from the shape itself. It's a T shape, so it's a T joint. And a corner joint. So if you are attaching the metal in the corner, then it's a corner joint. So you are welding at the corners. Okay. So that's for the joints. Typically, I ask such kind of questions when we have exams. So just be familiar with the types of joints. So I'll just ask you to label maybe and so on.
This one is called Mr. Office Welder. So So what you can do is they give you some tasks to weld. As you can see, there's a pipe with three cracks in it. If you want to weld, there are two welding tools on the right side. This is the stick welding rod, and this is MIG welding. So I'm just going to show. Let's go with MIG since this is what we have in the lab. On the bottom left, there is the weld button. So, second. So once you're done with the weld, there is a button called inspect, which will show if the weld has been like if the crack covered. Now it shows that the crack is covered. I missed any spot, it will show in the inspect. So in this case also it's a clean weld. But let me just purposefully try to miss something. So as you can see, you are just welding on top of the welded material. So the crack is completely revealed and so on. So it's just a game, but you can try it out. Just to have a feel of the welding machine. There are different levels as you progress. So it's just to pass time at least if you're bored. It's called Welding Art. In this case, welding is also done as art. Some people try to draw something by welding. So as you can see here, there are different shapes you can try. There's even Pikachu. And so on. I'll just show one example here. Just do come with ads. This you can move the welding tool and uses the similar method. The weld icon is there on the left, bottom left. And so on. This is showing that you can weld in whatever shape you want. You can choose some other colors as well.